just set this morning freshness, that beginning mind. No meditation, no mantra, no concentration, not even trying to be aware, just sit with closed eyes. Whatever can happen between you and me, let it happen. Let you feel your presence and my presence intensely. That's all. Let there be only your presence and my presence. Do not meditate, do not concentrate, do not repeat any mantra, just sit. Whatever happens, allow it to happen. Just cooperate. Whatever is happening in you, be with it. You can open your eyes. This is the scale with which I measure the depth of the person who can sit with himself without any entertainment or a technique or a method. That is the moment can we know how the being is. How the being is. Even a meditation technique is little makeup. Without even a technique, just as you are, how you are. Today we will work on death. I want to share with you experience which happened in my own life. You may understand lot of things about death, and you may have lot of questions about death. Then we'll analyze everything about death and try to understand intellectually, then experience in the being level. Not only intellectual, today we'll go through the experience of death. When I was wandering, doing yatra, parivrajaka yatra, it is supposed to be done by all the enlightened beings, especially when an incarnation lands on planet Earth. Before he starts teaching, it's like a preparation. He goes through and lives among the people to know really what needs to be taught. How people have updated themselves. He has to know. Only then he can update his teachings. How people have updated themselves or what kind of lifestyle they are living. So whether it is Shankara or Ramanuja or Buddha, whoever may be, it's a basic need for any incarnation in the planet Earth. It's a basic need. Go around, spend time with the people where they are, at their homes and where they live, in their level. Not going as a guest. The moment you go as a guest, now if I go as a guest to any house, I will not know the real situation of the house. Because the furniture, everything, they will make it new. Oh, Swamiji is coming. Not that way. Going as Aditi. Aditi means not informing the date you are coming. Titi means date. Aditi means who goes without the information of the date or time of arrival. Going as Aditi. Just walking in and living with them. It's a basic condition for any incarnation before he starts teaching. I can say all the Indian masters, Shankara, Ramanuja, Buddha, Swaminarayan, all Indian masters, they have done this. It is a basic need. I can say only the people who have done this yatra has a rich experience as something solid to contribute every being, because they know what people need. They know what people need. There are some enlightened beings, but who have not done this kind of yatra, they were not able to help millions. They were not able to help large number of human beings. For example, Ramana Maharshi. Ramana Maharshi is a great master, no doubt, but he was not able to contribute to large number of people. He was able to contribute only the people who gathered around him. That also only one path, one method. I am not underestimating or anything. I am just stating the fact to all of you. But when a master takes up this kind of this yatra, so much of enrichment happens in his very understanding about human beings. So now, you see, as an enlightenment experience, Buddha, Ramakrishna, Ramana Maharshi, everybody is one and the same. But the expression becomes very sharp. Expression is what is directly going to be helpful for you, useful for you. Expression becomes very sharp, very clear, user-friendly. That's the right word. User-friendly. When an incarnation takes up this Parivrajaka Yatra. So I became more user-friendly when I go and live with them. Because I know what really they want. How I can add to their life. What is the exact term I need to use to express the truth. Even this word user-friendly. So spirituality as a user-friendly version. So making it more user-friendly is the purpose of Parivrajaka Yatra. We call it spiritual journey. You are supposed to walk. There are some technical details. You are supposed to walk up to Rameshwaram, Puri, Dwaraka and Joshimat. These are all different places. If you are not from India, don't get confused. It's like a south, north, east, west corners of India. And there are 12 major Shiva temples spread all over India. The Jyotirlinga temples. So you are supposed to visit all that 12 Jyotirlinga temples. When I was doing that yatra, I think it took 9 years for me. But I started my yatra in a very young age. Even when I was in the home, I'll go and come. I'll go to different temples. I'll take up every year Sabarimala yatra. Different yatras I'll take up. Small. I'll come back. But this one stretch took the yatra. It was it added so much of understanding into me. Not enlightenment itself. Please understand. The enlightenment itself did not happen because of this yatra. Enlightenment happened different reason. Meditation or that is the reason for enlightenment. But this yatra added so much of understanding that I am directly productive to the society. I'm able to directly contribute to the society. I became user-friendly. I became a lot more simple. And I'm able to connect with people exactly what they need, what I can contribute. That became a lot more easy. So I always feel, even for my brahmacharis, I feel that they should travel and I send them sometime, do this kind of yatra. It really adds so much to you. And India is a very safe country if you wear this cloth. I'm really telling you. This cloth, India is a very safe country. Especially if you move towards north, nobody will ask you ticket or everybody will give you food. India is a very safe country if you are with this cloth. Only you should not disturb others, that's all. I was doing my Parivrajaka Yatra. One place near Varanasi, not Varanasi itself. Near Varanasi. Varanasi is the spiritual headquarters of Hindus. once in a life, everybody has to visit Varanasi and have darshan of Vishwanath. That's a tradition. 300,000 people come inside that city per day. Population is 300,000. 300,000 people per day in the city. I think largest floating population in the world is that city only. It's more than, I think, four times more than Vatican. So per day 300,000 people come inside the city, like floating population. It's a spiritual headquarters. Just near that city, in a small village, it's called Ghaziabad. Ghaziabad. Any of you from that area? Then you know what I am saying. Ghaziabad. There is an hospital just near that area, being little away from Ghaziabad. One sadhu was sick. So he was in the hospital, ICU, intensive care unit. Don't imagine American intensive care unit. Here we use the same word, but not same instruments. One sadhu was sick and he's in death bed. Sadhu means a monk. One monk was in death bed. In the north, the tradition is that any elderly sadhu, monk is sick, the youngsters, the brahmacharis will take care. So I was a young sadhu, so I naturally felt I should take care. I was staying in that village. So I went and started attending him, taking care of him. It was a very strong experience. I was taking care of him. He was about to die. Please understand, he was about to die. Not only he was about to die, the next bed, that man is also, he was also struggling for life. He was pulling and pushing, almost gasping for breath. So when I saw that guy was dying, not the monk, the next bed guy, I was able to see very clearly what is happening inside him. I was not able to help him because I am not completely, I can say, after my satori, but not fully became enlightened. Means the realization that I am an incarnation did not happen at that time. So only when the realization you are an incarnation happens, you will be able to help. It was a time when my body itself was getting prepared for that explosion. So I was not able to help, but I was able to see very clearly what is going on. Doctors are standing around him, trying to help, but what doctors can do? They can only console the relatives. Nothing else can be done. And they are trying to give all the supports, all possible support, medical support. And it's a, after all, a small hospital. Whatever they have, they are giving. That guy is grasping for breath. Just, I could see very clearly how the death was happening. I can say it is one of the strongest experience I had outside me. See, inside me, the strongest experience is realizing the mission or the purpose of this birth. That's what I call enlightenment. So that experience is the strongest experience happened inside me. The strongest experience I have ever had in my life outside me is this experience. I could see very clearly how that life source is settling or moving away from the body. First, actually, when I was able to see, I couldn't tolerate. I was not able to tolerate. One important thing I want you to know, if it is physical pain, when you see somebody suffering, it will only affect you 40%. If it is a mental pain, depression, when somebody is in depression, if you see, if you are able to connect, It will affect you 60%. If the pain is emotional pain and you are able to see and connect, it will affect you 80%. The more subtle the pain is, more you will also be affected. You understand what I am saying? If the pain is physical, other person's pain is physical, you will be affected only some 30%. If you see an accident, you will be affected only that much. But if you see somebody in a deep depression, and you know the purpose and the whole history and everything, it affects you at least 60%. And if the pain is subtle, emotional, deeper than the mental depression, emotional, or being level, and you see, and you are able to connect and understand, it will create a very strong effect in you. I not only saw physical or mental or emotional, I saw very being level. How that soul is struggling, how that individual soul is struggling with that body. So it was such a shock. Practically, I myself felt it. So I just want to run away from that area. But the Swami, this monk whom I am taking care, he gets frightened and he holds my hand. No, you have to be here. Stay here. I am going to die. Don't leave me and go away. He's 90, above 90. And what to do? And I was taking care of him, maybe I think 2 or 3 months. And he naturally became connected to me, very attached with me. And he said that even if I die, I should die at your lap. So you are the one who is taking care of me. I used to clean and take care of him. I really loved serving the monks from my young age. This is my life. From the young age, I will steal everything from the house and give it to the monks. Nothing, whether it is a cloth or food or... Of course, one nice thing with my mother, she will never say no when I am giving to sadhus. But my grandmother is very idiotic. I don't want to use any word. And she will keep an eye on me continuously. She will be sitting outside the house only. Usually in the Indian villages, the ladies will sit outside the gate with a stretched leg. They will be sitting and grinding that betel nut and betel leaf and the tobacco and chewing it and spitting all over the wall and everywhere. And that lady will be sitting there only. Still she is sitting there only. I left the house, became enlightened. Now the whole mission is there. Still she has not changed her place. And she is still alive. That's another one thing. And she will stretch her leg. And she will watch what I am carrying when I go out, what I am bringing when I come in. And sometimes she will check also, security check also. I have to go through security check also. Whether anything is hidden inside the tummy or anything. Serving sadhus was my passion. I always feel this whole tradition is alive just because of service to sadhus, service to the monks. It is they who kept the science. See, in the West, if you are doing some research in any field, that company will sponsor. If you are doing research in the medical field, the pharmacy company will sponsor. Each research, somebody has a vested interest. So they sponsor that research. If it is about space, the government sponsors. Like that. But if somebody wants to do a spiritual research, who will sponsor food and stay, shelter? India is such a great country. The whole country took the responsibility. We will sponsor. Go to any house with this cloth. North, the south, that it has been lost. In the north, you will have food, shelter and cloth. The whole country took up the responsibility. Anybody does spiritual research, we will sponsor. See, seeking is nothing but a spiritual research. That is what is the truth. So country decides, we will sponsor. So people who have taken up this research, who will take care of them? I always felt it's my responsibility. to take care of the sadhus. So I am not able to run away from him because he is telling, no, 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 stop, be here, otherwise I will die. And he is able to hear the sound from the next bed. And India people don't die softly. They shout. I don't know, in the West also same thing happens. They shout and cry, oh, Amma, it is paining here, they do all. What can be done? Even if you shout, nothing can be done. And that guy was dying. He was going through such a hard time. Let me describe exactly how it was. It's like the whole 6 feet was being, the body, whole body was being toned. That's what I felt, that consciousness. How the, see, if you are a small finger, if you have a cut, how you feel the pain. The same kind of cut is happening in the whole body. The skin is being peeled. That's what exactly, no, I saw that consciousness. Please understand, whatever I am talking is truth. I have to describe. It's like thousands of scorpions biting at a time. Have you had scorpion bite? Anybody? So 1,000, just multiply it. Every pore, the scorpion is bitten. It's like one side that soul is saying, soul means not the pure consciousness, the soul associated with all the engrams, desire, guilt, greed, lust, fear, anger, pain, pleasure. You see, when the pure soul added with all these engrams is called individual soul. Individual soul, when all the engrams are taken away, called pure soul. Pure soul is the cosmos. I can say individual soul. The individual soul was having a terrible suffering. The individual soul wants to stay in the body and enjoy. But body is saying, no, I am tired. I can't hold you anymore. I am done. Body just wants to relax. So the fight between the body and the individual soul is happening. The fight between the body and the individual soul. Every inch the fight is going on. The individual soul feels, even if the right leg goes, it's okay. Catch on. Hold on to left leg. Even if the left hand goes, it's okay. Hold on to right hand. Whatever parts it can hold on, it tries to hold on. But slowly, slowly, that part is saying, no, I am done, relax. I am done, relax. That part by part, it's dropping. When the lower body is getting dropped, the struggle was not too much. Only when the upper body it started, I could see very clearly the pulsating pain. I can say the whole being was vibrating with pain. See, yesterday after energy session, I saw so many of you vibrating with peace and bliss. How many of you felt that vibrating with the peace and bliss? And now understand, imagine the opposite. That is what is. Now you know what I mean by vibrating. How you vibrated with the peace, same way I saw that being was vibrating with pain. Whole being, it was such a shock. Slowly, that individual soul started moving out of the physical body. With all the suffering and pain, finally physical body dropped. When the breathing stops, that is the moment individual soul leaves the physical body. Then starts the next level fight, the next level body, the prana sarira, the next level body, that fight starts. See, there are 7 layers in you. I'll give you a simple description now for you to understand. So it's a 7 part of you. The body made out of flesh and bones and blood. This is the first layer, first body, physical body. The energy which is moving in you as a prana. See, in the 5 kind of air circulation happens in you. Prana vyana udana samana apana means going in, staying in, spreading all over the body and coming out and cleaning. These are the 5-year process happens in you. Going in, staying inside the body, spreading all over the body as an oxygen, as a life force, coming out and cleaning. Cleaning means even through skin, even you are sweating is because of the prana movement only. So 5-year movements are happening in you. All the 5-year movements are called the second body, second layer body, prana sarira. The third, the inner chattering which goes on continuously in you. The inner chattering is the third body, mental body. Fourth, the emotions which you are experiencing, fear or greed or anger, the emotion which spreads all over the body without the usage of words. Please understand, there are some emotions which can shake your whole being without the usage of any words. No need for any word to be uttered, but that emotion can shake you. That is what is fourth layer body, emotional layer. The fifth is the body you experience in the deep sleep. Body you experience in the deep sleep, where all the engrams are in a seed level, in a causal level. They are not giving you any experience, but they are not dead. In the causal level, this is the fifth layer. Sixth layer, the cosmic body, where you experience bliss. In your life, at least once or twice, you would have experienced bliss. That is the sixth layer. Sixth layer only continuously inspire you to be a seeker. If you are a seeker, seeking continuously, sixth layer is very strong in you. If you enrich the sixth layer, your whole life will be blissful. So that is the sixth layer. Seventh is the enlightenment, the ultimate enlightenment itself. So these are the seven parts of you. It's like a seven spare parts of you.